Hi everyone, today's Get Ready With Me video is going to be getting ready for a pure romance party with some of my girlfriends tonight. So if you'd like to see how I got ready, go ahead and keep watching. Starting out with a clean moisturized face, I'm going to go ahead and prime with Benefit's Porefessional. I'm just going to smooth that all over the center of my face and work out the extra outward. And then I like to give my face a mist of MAC Fix Plus before applying my MAC Studio Fix Fluid Foundation in NW18 with a Sigma F80 brush. And I'm just going to go around pressing that into the skin rather than rubbing. I'm gonna be filling in my brows using Anastasia's Dip Brow in Dark Brown. And then this is just an angled acrylic paintbrush I actually picked up at Michael's, which works amazing for this. And then once I get my brows all filled in as much as I want in the shape that I would like them to be, I go back with a little bit of MAC Pro Longwear Concealer and a concealer brush to just clean up the shape to make everything look very sharp and precise. We are making sure we are blending out all of this concealer very well though, because you don't want to see extra concealer on your face when you are done. I also use this concealer to prime my eyes sometimes, so I'm just going to put it all over my eyelid and spread it around with my fingers. All of the shadows I'm using today are going to be from my Holy Grail Lorac Pro Palette. First, I'm pressing a little bit of white just under my brow bone and on the inner corner, and then I'm going to start buffing a little bit of taupe into my crease with a fluffy crown brush. Now focusing mostly on the outer corner, we're going to start buffing in the color Sable, which is a little bit darker brown, just to give a little bit more definition and richness to our smokiness. And then I'm going to go back with a little bit of Espresso to make it even deeper on the outside corner so we get that nice soft smoky look. This is my absolute favorite eyelid trick, is to use the Balm's Mary Luminizer with a brush that you wet with MAC Fix Plus, and I pat that all over my lid to give a nice shimmery foiled look. And then using L'Oreal's Lacquer Liner in black and an e.l.f. angled eyeliner brush, I'm just going to start doing a winged liner, and I'm going to extend that out on the outer corner. And then after I get everything all filled in, I always go back to my outer corner to make sure that my wing is really nice and sharp with a makeup wipe or my nail, and you can see it just makes things much more precise. My go-to waterline liner is Benefit's Their Real Push-Up Liner, because it does not move at all. And then I'm gonna go back and just darken anything that needs to be a little bit darker. And then I'm gonna pop on my Eylure 126 lashes, which are my favorites right now, and give those a second to set. Tweezers are my absolute best friend when I'm putting on my lashes. So if you struggle putting on lashes, definitely try using tweezers. It will help you out a lot. I'm just buffing in a little bit of that Espresso shade on the bottom with a pencil brush just to give a little more smokiness, and then I'm going to use Benefit's Roller Lash Mascara to blend my natural lashes with my falsies and also to make my bottom lashes look nice and long. This clip is super long, so you'll notice I fast-forwarded it so you're not sitting there for 10 minutes, but I am just using my MAC Pro Longwear Concealer on the areas of my face that I would like to highlight. I'm just using my fingers today, and this is what I do on an everyday basis. I find that I can blend this concealer out fairly well with just my fingers, and I just use a tapping motion in all the areas until it is nice and smooth and spread. I'm sorry in advance, the next few clips are quite blurry. I got banana powder on the lens of my cell phone, actually. There it is, get it together, girl. But I am just packing that Ben Nye banana powder all over the areas we just highlighted with concealer to set and brighten those areas using the baking technique that is quite popular right now. Using my NARS Eta brush, I'm first gonna go in with my MAC Sculpt powder, and I'm gonna start doing my contour on my cheekbones, the sides of my forehead, my jawline, and also on the sides of my nose. And then I'm going to go back with a little bit fluffier brush to use the color Shadester from MAC to really blend out those contour lines and kind of bronze up the face a little bit more. Ugh, I swear a contour is a girl's best friend. With a fan brush, I'm going in with the Balm's Mary Luminizer to highlight the highlight areas of my face, my cheeks, nose, forehead, chin, and Cupid's bow. I love highlighters, so I tend to get a little carried away here. I'm gonna go in with Jordana's pencil in Tawny to outline the shape of my lips and overline them a little bit just to make them appear a little bit more fuller and plump. And then the lipstick shade I'm using today is Velvet Teddy from MAC, which has become one of my favorite nudes for every day because it just gives you a little bit more color than a nudie nude, and it is just absolutely gorgeous on a ton of skin tones and a ton of people. So it is one of my favorites right now. For my outfit, I'm wearing a black Forever 21 jumpsuit with a Forever 21 belt and just some simple hoops and my favorite Michael Kors watch. My hair I did with my Numi curling wand and my Weaveland clip-in custom 20-inch extensions. If you would like to see a tutorial on how I do this big, sexy, curly look, please leave a comment down below on YouTube. These shoes are from Forever 21 too, I believe. We're just on a roll. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Leave some comments down below, thumbs up, subscribe, and let me know what you thought. But until next time, I will see you guys later. Bye.